What's up, Internet? Welcome once again to the Free-to-Play Cast, brought to you by MMOBomb.com, your home for all things free-to-play related. I'm your host, Mike Byrne, a.k.a. Magic Man, and today is going to be a lot of fun. A lot of fun. Because we're going to be playing MMOBomb Jeopardy again, and boy, have we improved on the process a little bit. But first, let's get to the hosts who are going to be joining me today for their competition. First up, Mr. Jason Winter. How are you, sir?
Somebody's going to be humiliated today, and it's going to be me. Oh, wait, it's not going to be me. That's what I was supposed to say.
So I think that was the other way around. I don't think you want to be the one that's humiliated. Something like that. And his opponent, Mr. Zach Sharps. What's up, sir?
Not a whole lot. I have no idea how this is going to go, but we're here.
So
maybe
those
we'll
of
both
you,
be humiliated.
Those of you that watched the free-to-play cast a few weeks ago, a few episodes ago, we had Troy and Wilfredo square off in kind of a mini game because we did have news to cover that week. This week, yes, there is news, but none of it was like super big or anything. So if you're looking for news, head on over to MMOBomb.com. We've got all kinds of articles there. We've got what happened this week. The benchmark in PSO2 was released, and you can mess with character creation ahead of New Genesis launch in June. Jason's going to be putting up free Company of Heroes copies if you want to go get those. We've got a ton of Blue Protocol stuff that's going to go up today from yesterday's stream, if that's a game you're waiting for. And
for the 3% of you who are, or whatever it was.
Blue Protocol won. What are you talking about?
Yeah, sure it did.
It did.
Did it?
What?
How did Lost Ark not win?
Yeah, because it did.
Did I just look at the colors wrong? It was in second then. Like Blue Protocol was up there. We did a survey of most.
Conspiracy.
I thought it was. I thought that we got two different blues. That's why I got confused.
Yeah, Blue Protocol won.
Oh, okay. That's why I'm confused.
Blue Protocol won with Lost Ark right behind it.
Yeah, next time we got to use different colors.
I don't get to pick the colors, but yeah.
No, so clearly.
That light blue is that some other game. That's the 2 or 3%.
You're right.
Yeah.
You're right.
So Blue Protocol won.
Okay.
Yeah, see? Old Glory knows what's up in chat. We are live on twitch.tv/MMOBomb, as always, every Friday, 1 p.m. Eastern with a free-to-play cast. Next week, I do want to plug right now, next week's Friday stream is going to be a little bit special. We'll do the free-to-play cast at 1, and then we'll go to our free-to-play stream as normal at 2 o'clock. We'll be playing Neverwinter on the PC. We played that a couple of weeks ago, but that stream will be a live partnered giveaway with Cryptic Studios and Perfect World Entertainment, where we will be giving away randomly tons of keys for in-game goodies for the PC version of Neverwinter. And we even have a grand prize package that includes 2 bundle keys in-game and some real-life stuff outside of game, including a Neverwinter Sharendar poster and a Dungeons & Dragons reimagined screen or reincarnated Dungeon Master screen. So all kinds of stuff. I just put the post up on MMOBomb.com so you can go see the prizes. All you got to do is come hang out with us like chat is today, and you could have a chance to win all kinds of Neverwinter stuff. So make sure you're here next Friday for that stream. With that said, gentlemen, I asked Jason last Friday, I said, because he wanted to play Jeopardy. He'd seen it. He'd watched. And he said, I want to play. And I said, okay, who do you want your opponent to be? Because I had a feeling that the answer might have been Zach Sharps. And Zach, with his work schedule, I wanted as much time in advance to try and free up the time for him to come and do it. So last Friday, I said, Jason, who do you want to play? He says, Zach. I said, okay. Zach, it's a week away. I know it's, you know, normally Zach and I schedule things 2 and 3 weeks in advance just to be safe. I know it's a week away, but Jason wants to play in Jeopardy. Are you game? And Zach says, oh, hell yeah. Oh, hell yeah. I'm on.
Oh, Hellthurian, yeah.
So here's what we're going to do first. We got to decide who goes first. We have the Coin of Destiny, our quarter that we use for gambling in Phantasy Star Online and in other 50-50 decisions in games. Jason, you picked your opponent, so I'm going to give Zach the coin toss. Zach, if you win the coin toss, whoever wins the coin toss gets to decide who goes first. You can take the play or you can give it to your opponent. So Zach, heads or tails?
Let's go heads.
It is heads. So you get to decide, do you want the first question in MMO Bomb Jeopardy, or do you want to give it to Jason?
Well, if this was football, I would defer, but I'm going to go ahead and accept the kickoff.
Going to go ahead and accept the kickoff. All right, let's go ahead and get your dollar values up on the board. Right now, you're at zero. Zero
money. I swear we will finish higher than the last guys who played this.
Well, yeah, you definitely will. Well, I mean, I guess maybe not definitely, but there's a very, very high probability that you will, because we, let me swap views here, and I got to shrink this down just a little. There we go.
Now, question on the rules.
Yeah, I'm going to go through here in just a second.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to go through some rules here in just a second. So as far as the stream goes, gentlemen, you are free to leave the stream up, because while I'm reading the question, you will then have the chance to have the question come up on the screen for you. But you are to close chat at this point if you have it open.
Yep, I just closed it.
Chat, you are free to plug away answers if you want to. Keep score, and if you're watching on YouTube, let us know in the comments how you would have scored If you didn't cheat, and just throw dollar amounts down there.
Got my phone here. I'm going to just look up stuff on Wikipedia as we're doing this.
Google all of it. Just Google all of it. Now, since we don't have buzzers and we're all remote, the way we play is, Zach, you will be given the question. You will have a chance to answer, and as it being your question, you have to attempt an answer. If you get it right, you get the money. If you get it wrong, you lose the money. At that point, if you get a question wrong, Jason has the option to try to answer it. He is not required to. He'll let me know if he wants to try and take it. And if he does, he has the same gain or loss chance that you did. But if he skips on it, I'll just give the answer and we go to the next question. We go back and forth taking turns all the way through. All of the categories are free to play related, so you don't have to worry about anything outside of the free to play space. But I do reserve the right, as I did last time with the final Jeopardy question, to open it up to anything. It doesn't necessarily have to be free-to-play related for Final Jeopardy. Gentlemen, any questions on the rules?
Is there negative balances?
There are negative balances.
Okay. Yeah,
of course, you must phrase your response in the form of a question.
Yes.
What is?
Yes. Man. What is? Who is? All that stuff. Chat, are you ready? Let's go ahead and do this. Here we go. And watch this. Like, already it looks prettier. But check this out. Here we go. Ready? I'm going to cover my mouth.
Damn.
There it is.
Name that MMORPG.
All right, so the categories are...
Level caps.
Well, you should be reading this off.
There is audio for the stream. I'll read them to you in a minute. Metacritic scores. Famous figures. MMO bomb history. Game classes. Look at that. The present. Yeah, fancy. Good job. Yeah, you like it? You like it? I got to give a little shout out to Slide Lizard helping me out a little bit with some of the stuff in the background there. But for the categories, so for gentlemen, if you had the stream muted, they are Name That MMORPG, where you will be naming an MMORPG, Level Caps, which could be a question related to any level cap in a free-to-play game. You like the video over dude's voice. Metacritic scores, those are going to be the PC versions of games and referring to the editor scores, not the user scores. If a question asks you for a Metacritic score on a certain game, you will have the you will give me the tens. So like if you say 20s, as long as the answer is 20 through 29, you got the question right. So really you have a 1 in 10 chance of guessing, right? You could say 60s, and anything from 60 to 69 is yours. Famous figures, this can be in free-to-play video gaming. MMO bomb history, you better know your shit about the site you work for. And then game classes related to different classes in different games. Any questions about the categories, gentlemen?
No, I'm good.
Zach, right. The board is yours. Get us started, my friend.
Let's go name that MMORPG for 400.
Jumping right to the 400. Taking place in Arboria, this MMORPG was the standard for action combat for quite some time.
What is Terra Online?
The answer is indeed, what is Terra? Zach, on the board already with a quick 400. Chat, make sure, because I'm doing this on a second monitor, that I don't screw up any of the money. Jason, the next question is yours, sir.
Hey, screw me up. I should have like 2,000 by now.
Oh, I screwed it up already?
Yeah. I'm going to go with Metacritic scores for 200.
Metacritic scores for Neverwinter. Remember, it's PC version, editor's score that we're looking for, and you give me a group of the 10s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, something like that.
What is 70s?
What is 70s? It is indeed 74.
That's what I was thinking too.
Picks up 200 bones. Nice job, Jason. Zach, the board is yours again.
You gave Jason $22.
Yeah, that's definitely off.
That's wrong. Oh, yeah, I did. Hold on. Let me fix that. There we go.
All right.
You good? Hold on. I can't get the slide to go back. There it is. Okay. Jason, Zach, the board is yours again.
Let's go name that MMORPG for 200.
This popular free-to-play, mainly PvE MMORPG, is actually a sequel to a predominantly PvP MMORPG that still isn't free-to-play.
Huh.
Jason's smiling. I think he likes the way I did this question. Oh, no, now he's looking contemplative.
Jason is like, Zach, I'm going, huh.
This popular free-to-play MMORPG, mainly PvE, is actually a sequel to a predominantly PvP MMORPG that still isn't free-to-play. Chat, any guesses on this one? I thought this was really easy. That's why it's the 200.
There's only one that I can think of, but I don't know if its original was free to play or not.
Nobody in chat is even guessing. Wow.
I'm just going to go ahead and throw it out there. This is why I did a 200, because I won't be in the negative. I'm going to say, what is Ragnarok?
What is Ragnarok is incorrect. So that is negative 200 for Zach. Jason, do you want to take a stab at this one for 200 bucks?
No, I don't. I have no idea.
Gonna pass on it. Nisagra, you have the answer correct. Guardian Veil, you gave the right franchise, but you named the first one that isn't the free-to-play one yet.
I think I might have a clue, but I'm gonna skip it.
All right, it won't count. What is it? What is it? What's your guess?
Is it Vindictus?
It is not. It is Guild Wars 2. A predominantly PvE MMORPG that's free-to-play. That is a sequel to a predominantly PvP, not free-to-play game. Nisagra, you got that one right. Nice job.
I mean, technically, I guess.
That was Zach's question, so Jason, the board is yours.
I feel bad that I missed the Guild Wars 2 question now. It's the only one I'm going to get.
I thought you smiled right off the bat because you just, I got
no,
this
one. No, it didn't even come to my brain. I was thinking of more obscure stuff, but anyway. Give me Metacritic for 400.
Metacritic for 400, Blade and Soul.
Blade and Soul, I think, what is the 80s?
What is the 80s? It is 68.
Well, you should have told Zach that he could have 68. Guessed.
68, I don't think, right. I don't think any of you are going to be trying to steal the guild of the Metacritic scores ones off of each other.
I don't know. I mean, because if I'm like, if it's 70s or 80s, what do I pick? Oh, he picked 80s and was wrong. Well, I'm going to go 70s. I don't know.
All right. Fair enough. I'll give you the opportunities.
All right. Whatever. Whatever.
Jason,
I'm in the
you are
now.
Negative 200. Zach wasn't stealing that one. No way in hell.
No, I was going to say either 80s or 70s. I was not thinking 60s at all. So
Zach, yeah. The board is yours.
Let's go ahead and do level caps for 400.
Level caps for 4, the max tier of tanks in World of Tanks.
Why did I pick this category?
J- Jason's like, oh, please give me the steal.
The max tier of tanks in World of Tanks. It's a game I have never played.
Chat so is that's, screaming that's the answer. One. We've got multiple correct answers in there already.
I want to say it's through 7 and 10, but that's difficult.
Jason's like, no, it's not. Jason's like, I'm getting back into positives.
I don't know. I'm just going to say, what is 5?
What is 5 is incorrect. Jason, yeah. Would you like to steal this question?
Yes, I would.
What is the max tier?
I want to clarify to you that Mike did not consult me on any of the questions.
No, I didn't consult. I consulted Q on 1, just because I wanted to make sure the internet was correct. Other than that, I haven't consulted anybody. No, it's not going to tie it up because you lost 400.
It's going to tie it up.
Oh, true.
Oh, that's right. Oh, yeah.
It's negative. Yeah.
What is 10, or more specifically X, because they use Roman numerals?
Oh, my God. And look at the answer. Tier X with 10 in parentheses. Man, I feel like I maybe should have to give you double
credit.
Right.
Double credit for that one.
Yeah, no, you're not
getting that's
double.
Unfortunate.
All right. So that puts you at positive 200, and the scores have just swapped and puts Zach. Whoops. I think I got rid of my dollar sign.
Oh,
there we go. At negative 200. And Jason, the board is yours.
I'm kind of like Zach's strategy, though. I don't want to go with the negatives, so I'm going to take MMOBomb history for 200.
Ooh, jump into the hist. All right, here we go. Right. The name of the blog that eventually became MMOBomb.com.
A 200 question, damn. What is free MMO gamer?
That's correct. Yeah.
That is correct.
I knew that was like our gamer. YouTube channel.
Our YouTube channel still bears that URL.
Okay, that's how I know it. Okay, that's how I knew it. Okay.
All right, Jason, you gained another 200, putting you at 400 now.
I just retire now with my winnings. So I don't know if it's going to get any better than this.
It's not going to get better from here. Mr. Sharps, you're up.
I'm a millennial, so worst case, let's go further in debt. Let's go name that MMORPG for 600.
This MMORPG sequel didn't quite work out, as it departed from the original's 2D chibi look in favor of a 3D cartoon design.
What is Maple Story? 2.
Ah, all right, there you go.
Okay, all right.
I thought you were just going to be fine with Maple Story.
Because it said this sequel, so I was like,
yeah,
I'm going to give him a chance.
Because I watched last Jeopardy, and you weren't that precise. I was like, Maple Story? So,
all right, that ties the game chat like that one.
I knew that
like
instantly. As soon as I saw the question, I'm like, yes.
All right, Jason, tie game. The board is yours.
I want to comment, though, that you probably should have gone with a different color on your text if we got that white behind us, so it's like...
Should have been yellow, yeah.
Anyway, it should be green for all the moolah.
True. And then go right. Red.
Well, Zach's trying to run this category, so I'm going to go with Name That MMORPG for 800.
Oh, for the dollars. Okay. This first expansion for Rift was also the last expansion to see a physical copy for sale. I can just see like the gears going on both of the hosts.
Streamed 9 hours of this on Game Breaker. Me, Q, and Gary.
Mad Martha says, "Crap, that's tough." Not really. I mean, you just got basically you got to remember the first expansion for Rift is what it is. This first expansion for Rift was also the last expansion to see a physical copy for sale.
What is Storm Legion?
There you go.
That's what it was. Okay.
It is. What is Storm Legion?
I knew what the cover looked like.
I knew
like,
Storm.
But
I
was
remember that,
like
but I can't remember what the rest of it was.
Yeah, that's where I was. That was tough. Yeah.
$800 to take him up over a grand. Wow. Nice grab on that, Jason. You had me a little worried there. Right. Zach, your question.
That's his finish to the category. Name that MMORPG for 1,000.
The first $1,000 question. Travel the world of Alien in this MMORPG developed by Alid's team and Obsidian Entertainment.
Allods Online, or what is Allods Online? Sorry.
What is Allods Online? I'll give you the credit for the what is incorrect. Jason, would you like to try to steal this question?
I know this. I know that word alien. I know I've written articles about that 100 times, but I'm just... I will not steal it. I can't remember.
Oh, I know what it is.
Yeah, you reacted too fast. I put the developers in there to purposely cause a little...
Oh my god, it's Skyforge, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Okay. Oh.
I was like, well, you know, if I put that it was developed by Allod's team, somebody might
was
try to gut
it. Was it developed by the Allod's team, though? I thought it was just Obsidian.
Yeah, it it's Obsidian and Allod's team. They're both there in the question.
Oh, that kills me.
All right, so negative 600 for Zach, 1,200 for Jason, and it's Jason's board.
I'll go back to Metacritic for 600.
Metacritic for 600. Fortnite.
Now, Fortnite, is it Save the World or Battle Royale?
That's a good question.
It's Fortnite. You're fine. It's Fortnite. If it was Fortnite Save the World, I would have said Fortnite Save the World.
Okay, fine, fine. what is the 80s?
Okay, hold on. I got to make this screen a little bigger so I can see it. Okay. I just didn't want to reveal an answer if Zach was going to. It is the 80s. 81.
Okay.
I'm actually surprised I didn't break the 90s. But...
Yeah. 3.0 user score.
Yeah, you like that?
That's great.
Zach, you're bored.
Let's try and get back in the positive, but the question is with what?
Napoleon got 80s on that one. Nice job, Napoleon.
Let's go level caps for 600.
Level caps for 600 for Mr. Zach Sharps. The current level cap, not the power cap, in Destiny 2.
I think I know the answer, but I'm going to think about it for a little bit longer since I screwed myself the last one.
What is Allods Online? I think you guys, by the way, need to appreciate a little bit how long it actually takes to come up with this many freaking questions.
Oh, yeah, especially not making them, like, ridiculously obscure, too.
Well, I don't think they're obscure. They're challenging but fair.
No, I'm saying without.
Oh, yeah, without getting into this bizarre stuff. Ninja Pandas, that guess is incorrect.
I'm thinking that this is my gut. What is 20?
What is 20 is incorrect. Jason, would you like to try and steal this?
No, I wouldn't, because I don't even recall there is a level cap. And all I care about is my power cap.
Yeah, we're talking about the level cap, not the power cap. The level cap is 50.
Is 50. Are you sure?
I am
sure. I don't remember leveling 50 times.
I am sure. It was. When was the last time you played? Because it was 20, then 30, then 40, then 50 with the expansions.
Oh, I wasn't considering the expansions. So I was right on the vanilla. Well, that's unfortunate.
Negative 12.
Zach, you're going to owe Mike money.
Well, that's why the question said the current level cap. The current.
Yeah, I know. I know.
That was Zach's question. So, Jason, you're bored, my friend.
Well, let's branch out a bit and go for famous figures for 200.
I like this category. This was a fun category to put together. I don't know if anybody's going to get any of them, but we'll see.
Oh, that's why I picked the 200.
Yeah, I think there's like, I think the 2 and the 400 might be pretty easy if you think about it.
Okay.
Oh, I just remembered what the 200 one is. I like this one, actually. Famous figures.
Okay.
Who is this?
I gotta wait for it to come up.
I know Zach is looking at this like, I got 200 if he gets this wrong. Who is this person?
I don't have a clue.
All right. Negative 200. Perfect. Hey, Zach, I got to ask you, would you like to try to steal this question?
Of course. What is Gaming Ethos, a.k.a. the host of Free to Play Weekly, and also the creative director of Samurai Zero?
Yeah, that is correct. So you gained 200. Speaking of that, Zach, how's your game going? Want to give us a little update, little plug?
Yeah, it's going good. It's been working on the combat system, trying to get the combo system fully working, with combo indicators and whatnot. And also tried out Unreal 5, which was pretty neat, but definitely not ready for Unreal 5 at this point. So I went back to Unreal 4. So yeah, it's moving along though. Should have a video up this weekend, and maybe two actually videos up this weekend. So
nice. Yeah. Nice. Well, it is your board, Zach. You have managed to climb back to negative 1,000.
So that famous figures one kind of gave me a little bit of confidence. Ooh. But I'm generally not that good with names.
Gotcha, gotcha.
But I am going to try and either go very deeply in debt or get myself out of this hole. So let's go famous figures for 1,000.
Whoa! Jumping straight down to try and get to the zero.
See, the smart thing would be just to let Jason play and then, you know, take ones that he gets wrong, but...
Who is this?
Oh, jeez.
Who is that?
Who is that? I don't even recognize the face, so this is not good at all.
He's like, well, shit. Mad Martha, no. No. Lagwin, yeah, I mean, you have the right place. You just got to get the name.
The right
Does he have
place.
The right place?
Lagwin, you the absolutely... Right you she, Lagwin absolutely knows where this lady works. 100% you got that right. Can't remember her
Man.
Name.
Man, I have no idea.
Uh-oh. All right,
that's not good. I'm just gonna say what is I have no idea.
What is I have no idea is incorrect. Jason, would you like to try to steal this?
I would like to steal that, yes.
Who is this?
Who is Holly Longdale?
That is Holly Longdale, formerly from EverQuest, now on the WoW Classic.
And that's exactly why I shouldn't win that category.
I knew she was working for Blizzard. I didn't remember what capacity.
Which I thought was one of the most intelligent grabs on Blizzard's behalf for WoW Classic. I was like, Holly has been on EverQuest forever. She knows how to manage Classic games. Yeah, negative 2,000 for Zach, 2,600 for Jason. Jason, it is your question.
I'm just going to keep it cheap because I don't want Zach to screw himself over. So I'm going to go with MMOBomb history for 400.
The result of viewers submitting and voting, this replaces first on YouTube videos for real MMO bombers.
What is mounted?
It is what is mounted. Picking up another 400. Take yourself to $3,000. Zach, the board is yours. Mad Martha says, Jason, you now have enough cash for a Series 3000 NVIDIA card.
Or at least box.
I am going to try and not dig myself a further hole. Let's go Zach's game like, classes.
Screw those thousands. Game classes for 200. This Alice Online. This Alice Online class can conjure up demons to aid the player in battle. Of course, you grab this one.
The obvious answer feels like it's not correct.
I'll give you a hint. You're right.
It's only a 200 question. It's only a 200. Even I think I know this. I've never played the damn game.
What is Necromancer?
Ooh, I'm going to give it to you because I did put it on the slide. Summoner will also accept Necromancer due to translations in that
game. Yeah, I would have said Summoner, but yeah, okay.
Yeah, because I swear I've seen Necromancer at one point. So
nice grab.
Okay.
All right, hold on. Let me get you back to 1800.
That is painful, though, that it happened to be Allods Online.
I totally... But like, I mean, I'd still be I know the questions, but I don't remember where most of them are at this point. Because I made this like 2 or 3 days ago, so I wouldn't be rushing. That was Zach's question. So, Jason, you're bored.
Yeah, Zach's wall is definitely wider than me, and we're losing his last zero there. Just make sure it's 1,800 back, not 180.
No, it's 1,800. I'll move it.
I'll take a little bit of a chance. I'll go MMO Bomb History for 600.
There, I moved it down a little bit.
You got
bit,
some
so
cash to spare, Jason.
MMO Bomb History for 600. This two-word phrase is commonly yelled by the MMO Bomb team when testing things like fall damage in a game.
What is for science?
It is absolutely for science. Chat was like, yeah, we know that one. That puts you at 3,600. Ninja, yeah, everybody's now coming through with for science.
Luis Jason, is paying this out as a bonus, right?
Jason answered so fast. Magic Man's the king of that one. You shut your mouth.
But Zach, I do that even when I'm in a game that's not, I'm not streaming or MMOBomb.
I do too. It's like so ingrained. I'm sitting here all alone and playing Rocket League, and I just zoom away at the ball, totally miss, and I yell, for science! Go ahead, Zach. The board's yours.
Yeah, let's go level caps 200.
The current level cap in Lord of the Rings Online.
I'm not totally certain I know that.
Yeah, I kind of figured so that even... expansions. Yeah.
I think I can take a guess at it. I think I know what it is, but I'm not 100% sure.
All the guesses in chat so far are incorrect. Mad Martha, like, when I was making the questions, I kind of pegged, like, Zach will probably get this one. Jason will probably get this one. I'm going to be honest. Even this question, knowing Jason's history with Lord of the Rings Online, I was like, I don't know if he'll get this. Like, he hasn't played in, like, multiple expansions, so he might not even remember where it's at now.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm just going to take my best guess with it. What is 120?
120 is incorrect. Ninja, your answer in chat is correct. So that's negative 200 for Zach. But Jason, would you like to try to steal this? Knowing that 120 is incorrect?
I would, and I'm grateful because I wasn't sure if it was 120 or something else. So now that Zach eliminated that, I want to say, what is 130?
It is 130.
Okay, all right.
They must have recently increased it, didn't they?
Yeah, I don't know how recent it was, but yeah. But yeah, that thing is, I thought it was 120 for all, but I was like, I think they did the expansion, they raised it to 130.
Because I think when I played it last, it was 120. That's the only reference point here, I had. Yeah.
Jason, the board is yours. You got a commanding lead right now, but there's a lot of high dollar amounts you guys have been avoiding.
Sure. Sure. I'll go MMOBomb history for 800.
Now, this is where we separate the boys from the men on these questions now.
It'll be the end of the
road. In 2014, this game added the MMOBomb logo as an in-game pet character.
I was so hoping that was about something else related to our logo, but
could you imagine on Jeopardy if somebody was like, oh, Alex, I was really hoping that question was going to be different.
You started saying it, and I was like, yes, it's good. Oh, no, it's not that one. Shoot. I don't want to say it because it might be
a
$1,000.
Yeah, that's like preemptively hit the buzzer. Oh, I wish that was different.
What was an in-game pet character?
In 2014,
that sounds familiar too,
like... this game added the MMOBomb logo. We're in multiple games. That's why I had to be a little more specific here on what they implemented. Because we were a car in one game. We have a cape in
that's what I was thinking.
Adventure
I was thinking
Quest
of the car
3D.
Game, so
like, we've got MMOBomb stuff in multiple games.
Well,
so
a former game, we have a car.
In 2014, we have flags, we have flares, like we have all kinds of shit. In 2014, this game added the MMOBomb logo as an in-game pet character. Yeah, Dauntless was one of the flares. Yeah.
I'm just going to say, what is Maple Story?
It is not Maple Story. So you're going to lose 800. Zach, this one's a little bit of a toughie. How much do you know your history?
I'm not going to take an official guess on this one.
All right, so officially you pass.
One of my official, one of my official guesses was Maple Story, but I'm thinking Trove.
Is not
was
Trove.
That 2014?
That wasn't around then. No.
This was Airmech.
Oh yeah, I have no idea. Oh,
I have a little picture of the guy. He looks pretty awesome. Looks pretty awesome. Jason, that was your question. You lose 800. Zach, the board is yours. A $5,000 gap still can be made up very, very quickly with the dollar amounts on the board. Retribution. We have the keychain dangling. What is that? Like the little thing you can add.
Yeah, I'm gonna go game classes for 400.
Game classes for 400. Ninja, can you moderate that? Thank you. Oh, you got it. This squad specialization unit in Enlisted relies on distance and aim in taking out single targets.
So I've been playing Enlisted a lot. So I'm just going to think about this real quick to make sure I don't.
Like, what is it called? Like, I'm in the same boat as you, probably. Yeah. Like, what?
Yeah.
This squad specialization unit in Enlisted relies on distance and aim in taking out single targets.
Also, U comes after Q. We all know that. We learned that in second grade.
Oh, I don't think it's scout. Let's say what is
clearly
sniper.
It's a typo. Not me, just not knowing how to spell squad. But thanks for pointing it out. Like, the rest of this didn't take hours and hours to do or anything. But thanks for that one, Jason.
Look, it's not the first misspelling I've seen, but anyway, I've been nice.
Really? What? Yeah. What else did I misspell?
Never mind. I don't remember what it was. It was like one of the earlier questions, but I didn't.
Oh, now I'm gonna look at all of them. No, specialization is one of those words that differs by region, whether you use the Z's S's. So, Mad Martha, I'm not taking that one as incorrect.
Oh yeah, don't listen to Mad Martha when it comes to spelling. He wants to use in everything.
What is sniper?
It is snipers. Yeah, it is snipers.
I was hoping it wasn't something obscure that I forgot.
I had
because the problem is I started
to word
a little
that
caliber
one carefully because I didn't want either of you to pick the like mortarmen.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Like I started playing caliber, and their sniper class is called marksman. So I was like, wait, it's sniper, not marksman, right?
Yeah.
So Zach gaining a little ground. Jason, the board is yours.
I'm a little scared here because if I miss a $1,000 question, yep, I lose a lot. So it's like, yep, I kind of want to just take the weak
ones. If
you
get one, then you pull really
Zach's
far ahead.
On the landmines. Give me famous figures for 800.
Ooh,
I'll take that one.
Jumping to eight in famous figures. Who's that?
That is, I haven't seen it yet.
I think Jason has a guess, but he's a little nervous on it.
No, Jason doesn't really have a guess.
Oh, really? Yes, Q, you got this one right. I knew Q would get this one right. This is not the one I consulted with Q on, by the way. That one was a level cap question.
Honestly, that gives me a little bit of a clue if Q knows it. Like, I feel like that almost... I'm trying to think of games Q knows now.
Yeah. I don't think it's going to help you.
Probably not.
I don't think it's going to help you.
But I'll try. Who is Ragnar Tornquist?
It is not. It
okay.
is not.
So no, that's a
negative 800. Zach, you want to take this?
No, I'm passing. I have no idea.
It's Jason at 2,200. This is Mr. Todd Harris, formerly of High Res.
Oh.
Yeah.
I was trying to think High Res. I couldn't think of a name from High Res.
Yeah, that was not even going to be anywhere close to my guess.
Your board, right. Zach.
Let's go game classes for 600. It's been treating me good.
The term commonly used to reference a MOBA player that farms creeps between lanes.
What is jungler?
It is jungler. 600. Trying to creep back in this.
Hmm. I got to get something right now. See, that's the problem. Is the reason we get in the negative is because we have to answer. It's not like we can't.
Yeah, there is no option to not answer. It's two players.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, Old Glory, I did get your email about Caliber. Jason's going to be checking that one out for a first look.
Yeah.
We didn't know. We had covered it before, but we didn't know it was actually accessible now because they have not sent anything in forever. So thank you for the heads up.
Yeah. I'll go game classes for 800.
Yeah, that was Zach's question, so it is yours. Game classes for 800. Singing songs to inspire allies, this Ion class wields a harp as their weapon.
Well, there's an obvious answer, but I don't know if it's what it's called an Ion. It almost certainly isn't.
I don't know if it would be the $800 easy question.
That's my point. That's like...
Ninja Pandas, that's exactly the word Jason is thinking of. It is wrong. I'll give you both the... If you say bard, you're wrong. So don't say bard.
Yeah.
No, nobody in chat has it yet. Somebody in chat has
it. I'll go the other simple route and I'll call it... What is singer? No, and I wouldn't be singing. No, because never mind. I'm not going to get it.
Go ahead.
You have singing in there. What is...
Q, yeah.
I'm trying to think of just another word for. Can I go to my thesaurus.com or something right now?
Nope, it wouldn't help you.
Yeah, I probably wouldn't. What is Soprano.
It is not Soprano. That's negative 800.
Putting you. So this one's hard 14. For me because I played a class called Chancer and Ion, but at the time they did not use a harp as their weapon, but they did sing songs to inspire their allies, hence the name Chancer. So
might be why Mike specifically added what weapon they use.
So that to me is either a curveball or a trick question that they did end up getting a harp at some point.
They did not. They did not.
They did not.
No,
so right, not enough of the clues. Enough with the clues now.
I'm passing.
Are you taking the question or not? You're passing?
I'm passing. Right, yeah. Passing. I was just singing through.
You were so close, Jason. Songweaver.
Oh.
Yeah, you said songstress or something like that. I was like,
yeah, I wouldn't have gotten Weaver, though.
We so close. Yeah. Chat Q said you were close, too. Zach, you're bored. And all of a sudden, the game isn't as runaway as it was 10 minutes ago.
Let's finish out game classes for 1,000.
Knocking it off the board, this Spellbreak class that uses the power of Earth to defend themselves and crush their foe. The Spellbreak class that uses the power of Earth to defend themselves and crush their foes.
Oh, man. That's not good. I played Spellbreak, but I can't remember what they name their classes.
Uh-oh. This one could hurt for a grand.
Yeah. That uses the power of Earth to defend themselves. Because I have a hard time thinking that they just named themselves Earth. Earthbender.
Earthbender.
Like, that's the obvious
one. What class
one.
Do you play in Spellbreak? Earth. Old Glory, no, it is not The Rock. It is not The Rock. Capital T, capital R.
Oh, geez. This hurts. The only thing I can think of is what is obelisk.
It is not. That's gonna cost you a grand, Jason. I'm thinking the answer is no.
What else is new?
Yeah, the answer is no. I'm not even trying it. Nope.
The answer is what is Stone Shaper.
Yeah, that was even anywhere close to what I was thinking. Okay. So,
you're bored, Jason.
Does it have to be?
This was fun with the $200 and $400 and $600 ones.
Yeah, no kidding. Give me Metacritic for 800.
Ooh, going back into Metacritic. Gwent the Witcher card game.
Going on a limb here, I'm going to say, what is the 90s?
Because everyone loves Witcher crap. The 90s is incorrect.
Oh.
So that one's going to cost you 800, putting you at 600. Zach, would you like to steal this?
That's what I was thinking, too. So I'm going to say yes, I'm going to take it. What is the 80s?
Zach, using the Witcher card game as a rebound.
Oh, I'm very glad I didn't get that one because I would have did the same thing as Jason and said the 90s.
It is the 80s. So that was a $1,600 swing right there. Zach, can you keep the momentum going now that the board is yours?
Steer clear of MMO bomb history.
Nobody wants that last one.
Metacritic scores is intriguing.
Still got two level caps, and everybody bailed on famous figures.
I think I have a decent, at least, guess for most Metacritic things. So let's go. Let's Metacritic for 1,000.
Shot online.
Oh, fuck. Oh, jeez. Really?
I think I have a pretty good handle on Metacritic scores. Let's go with, that
Everything else was like, okay, I've heard of that game. This one, I have no idea. So what is 50s?
Oh, my God.
Let's go. Yes. Shovelware for the win.
Yes. It is now an $800 game.
Yes.
Oh my God, Jason, the board's yours. Zach like was so excited his mic gained out and went quiet while he was screaming. All right, he rolls the Witcher $1,600 swing into another $1,000 gain.
Oof. All right. Give me a famous figure for 400.
Famous figures. Who's this?
My stream is lagging out just now, so hold on a second.
You're fine.
No, I mean, I can't see the picture.
Oh. look on, in Discord. You can see.
It's coming. Maybe?
Yeah, you can look in Discord. That's why I shared my XSplit presentation as my camera today.
Okay, there we go. I got it. Oh, okay. Who is Tim Sweeney?
That is Mr. Tim Sweeney from Epic Games. Picking up 400.
Gotta get going in the positive direction again.
Back at an even grand. Zach, trying to pull the comeback. Four questions left before Final Jeopardy. You gotta get into the positives, though, Zach. That's the important part.
I know. MMOBomb history is a landmine for me. Famous figures could be fine, but judging by the 800 and 1,000, no idea. I want to say let's go level caps, but part of me kind of wants to go the famous figures. Let's go famous figures for 600.
Famous figures for 600, Zach. Who is this?
It's pixelated. That's not good.
Her name is not pixelated.
Yeah, I mean, for me right now, this kind of looks like the Mona Lisa, which is not good in terms of quality.
Well, I don't think Jason will mind if I give you a hint. It is not the Mona Lisa.
No.
She was actually a very famous free-to-play developer back in the 1600s.
Yeah, Mona Lisa. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, the only thing that's coming to mind is based off of like the shape of the face, because, like I said, I can't see the finer details. That's what I am. I'm in Discord.
Oh,
that's
then
the problem.
Pull the stream open real quick. Just don't look at chat. Chat doesn't have a guess. Guardian Veil, you have the right product. Well, Wade, previously the right product.
I'm not going to open up because the only one I can think of is, I want to say her name starts with Amy, but I don't think that's correct. I'm just going to say, what is Amy? Because I don't know what the last name would be off the top of my head.
It is not Amy.
Okay.
Jason, would you like to steal?
I would not. I have no idea who that is.
I was hoping he would throw up like a Chris Metzen or, you know, someone
else.
That is
Jade Raymond, formerly of Ubisoft fame and Stadia fame.
Not even anywhere remotely in my mind who that would be.
Three questions left. Things are still within reach for both players here. Jason, the board is yours, which means two of these three questions will 100% come your way.
Yeah, I know Zach's going to stay away from the history one. So the question is, I'll take level caps for 800 then.
The current class level cap in Phantasy Star Online 2. Each class can reach this level cap in PSO2 right now. Yeah, Ninja Pandas, if you got that wrong, I was going to take a flight over there and strangle you. You got it.
No, I wish I would have watched your streams more.
Oof.
But I'm going to say, what is 80?
It is not 80.
I'm passing, by the way.
This puts you in a very precarious situation.
I'm passing because I have no idea. If you would have asked me this probably about 4 or 5 months ago, I would have known, but I don't know at this point. So I'm going to take an unofficial guess.
Okay, so we're passing officially on the question. What's your guess?
35.
No, it's 100. 100.
Oh, yeah.
I know it was up there because I remember seeing you in the 70s at one point.
Yeah, it started at 70, 75.
I thought maybe like the class level was different from the overall level. Yeah. All right. Let's go ahead and close it out. Level caps for 100. Or 1,000, sorry.
The level cap in Secret World Legends. This is the one I conferred with Q just to make sure what I had found was still correct.
Oh, that's difficult. I think I know what it is, but...
Me too. I think I know too, but I don't know enough to wager $1,000 on.
That one's hard.
A correct guess ties the game going into that $1,000 MMO bomb question.
Because so part of me thinks it's either 60 or 80.
Q, you got it right.
I'm fairly certain it's not 70.
I'm not shocked since we conferred on this one.
And I don't think it's anything beyond that because the game kind of died. I'm going to say what is 80.
What is 80 is incorrect. Oh.
Interesting. I'm very curious what it is now.
I'm trying to decide if I want to go for
this. Jason, do you want to steal
this
one?
If I get it wrong, I'll still be in the positives if I get the other question right, which I kind of need to get right anyway. If I get that wrong, I'm in the negatives anyway. So, yes.
And Ziva.
I'm going to lodge a guess.
Official guess. What do you got?
Ooh.
What is 50?
Oh, no, Zach, you got it right.
Wow, 50. Huh,
yes.
Right. Interesting.
All right.
Well, GG's, Jason.
Jason, you got the last question on the board, MMO bomb history for 1,000. Not counting a video from back when it was officially free MMO gamer. What is the most viewed video on MMOBomb.com's YouTube channel?
What was free MMO gamer? Oh, shoot. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. I know what video you're talking about.
That was when it was free MMO gamer. We're not counting that video. It was like a top 10 from 2011.
Yes, I know. The old top 10 video. That's what I was thinking.
Yeah, we're looking for the next one from the highest viewed MMOBomb.com video.
Yes, okay.
It is not V4, Old Glory.
It's an old episode of Hi-Lo. No. I still almost feel like I should know this.
That is incorrect, Mad Martha. That is incorrect, Terra Nova.
It would have to be an older one.
Lagwin, get off my porch. Lagwin's been watching MMO Bomb content for like a decade now.
I want to say.
And we appreciate it. Ninja Pandas, I am convinced that you just went and looked that up. It took the appropriate amount of time for you to come back immediately with the right answer there.
What is the first look for Star Trek Online?
Oh, I thought you were going to get it when you started that way. No.
Yeah, I know it's got to be a first look. I just tried to think of an older game from around there.
No, that is incorrect.
Okay.
Zach, would you like to try to steal this one?
I mean, I'm in the negative already, so technically...
Like, yup, I absolutely looked it up.
Technically, I'm not even allowed to do the final question since I'm in the negative, so I might as well just go further in the red. The only thing I can think of is based off of my channel's performance back in the day, Terra Online videos were extremely hot. So I'm going to say, what is the first look for Terra Online?
That is incorrect as well.
Okay.
That is incorrect. But I appreciate that you were just taking a stab on that one.
YOLO it. Yep.
Yeah, knowing the financial.
The other one I was thinking was maybe Team Fortress 2, but I think
this is going to surprise some of
you. Only the thing I was thinking is a top 10 video, but.
Yeah,
it's the Neverwinter first look.
Wow.
Yeah. Oh, Neverwinter.
Okay. Over 1.2 million views.
Interesting. Mm.
That completes the board. Jason, $200. Zach, negative $2,800. I believe that means even without Final Jeopardy, we have a winner. Jason, congratulations.
Congrats, Jason.
I wouldn't exactly call it a stellar victory.
But hey, look, we got to do the final Jeopardy. We're going to go through.
A victory is a victory.
I'm ready. I'll write some crap down here or whatever. And
yep. Give me a second. Since of where we stopped, I got to flip through to get to where we need to be. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. All the mapping. Okay. So, final Jeopardy.
Oh, we could find the one that you spelled wrong.
All right, so the final Jeopardy category is upcoming titles. Now, Jason,
upcoming titles.
I got to ask you, since this was a less than stellar performance by both players, are you willing to put the game on the line? The winner take all on this question. Are you willing to give Zach that final gasp of hope that the dollar amounts don't matter since Zach can't play anyway and just put it all on the line? Whoever gets this one right wins, whoever gets it wrong loses, and if you both get it right, it's a draw.
No, if we both get it right, I still win. Because
all right, okay, that's fair. I'll give that
to
you.
He has to win and I have to lose in order for it to happen, all right?
All right. Are you willing to do that?
A win for me. Okay.
Are you willing
I'll do
to
it
do
that it? Way.
You do it that way. I'll Zach, that. If you get it right and Jason gets it wrong, you win today's
Very honorable round. Of you, sir.
It is honorable. Right. Well, I mean, he had $200 and you had $2,800. It's not like either one of you blew the other
True,
one out.
True, yeah. That Skyforge question just destroyed everything.
The category is upcoming titles. And normally at this point, I would ask you to write down dollar amounts. We can skip that. Keep in mind that the Final Jeopardy category is not necessarily limited to free-to-play only. It may be. It may not. Okay? So please pull out a piece of paper and a pencil so that I can show the question.
I have a Sharpie.
And you, that's fine too. Zach Sharpies. and when you are ready, let me know.
I'm good.
I'm good.
All right. Here's the final Jeopardy question. While we don't know the payment model yet officially, Weyland-Yutani will be happy to see players squad up in this PvE shooter. While we don't know the payment model yet officially, Weyland-Yutani will be happy to see players squad up in this PvE shooter. By the way, in the original version of this entire board and everything, I had music mapped into it and an intro mapped into it. And then I was like, yeah, that the Jeopardy theme's copyrighted. I'm going to go ahead and take all that stuff out.
I recognize that name and I know what it's about, but I don't know that I know the name of what this is.
Chat is on the same board as you, Jason. They know the topic, but they're not quite sure on the game. Nobody's gotten it yet.
PvE shooter.
Terra Nova, congratulations. Ninja Panda, congratulations. You Googling bastards. Old Glory, that is absolutely incorrect. You got to respect chat, though, by the way. When you're like, yeah, you totally Googled that. They're like, yeah, you got me. Chat's like, yeah, I got it. You got me. I Googled that.
Well, I've got a guess down.
You got a guess down. Zach, do you have a guess written down?
I'm just going to write down a word. I have no clue. I'm thinking I know at least a word of something that's a PvE shooter that we don't officially know the name of, and I totally spelled the word wrong, but that's all right. We're good. All right.
All right. Zach. Yeah. Since you have to get this right, let's go to you first. Go ahead and show us what you wrote.
So I forgot the L initially, by the way, but I'm just going to go with that.
Blood?
Blood. Yeah.
Is
that blood in it?
That is incorrect. Okay. It does not have blood in it. Jason, okay. Do you have a guess?
No clue.
This is probably a game that was already launched. There's so many games in this with this IP. I don't know which ones have launched, which ones aren't. So I'm just going to go with what is Alien Isolation.
It is not Alien Isolation. That's already launched. That's a single-player game. It is in the Alien franchise, though.
Yeah,
chat did pick
Weyland-Yutani
up with Weyland-Yutani being referenced.
Alien one. Yeah.
We are talking about, what the hell? That is the wrong slide.
I was going to say Stone Shaper.
I went back a slide, sorry. Aliens Fire Team.
That's what it's called, yeah.
Upcoming squad-based PvE.
Yeah, game. Now I remember seeing the video for that, right.
Yeah, it looks pretty awesome. I'm interested. We talked about like the concern being replayability. Like, are they going to have enough there to make you want to keep doing it? Gentlemen, great game. Jason, congratulations. You walk away the winner.
Do you have anything you'd like to say
to your fans?
I have more than the last winner had.
You do? Yeah, you
I'd like
doubled.
I'd say two times as much.
Yeah, you doubled what the last winner had. So we're on a track record where our first winner left with $100 and our second winner left with $200 and our second winner had a lot more money on the board to try and grab since we went with the 1,000 version and the full six categories, five questions. Jason, here you get 30 seconds with your fans.
I'd like to thank everyone for their support. I would, however, like to screw you, Ninja Panda, for that one text you sent me that was wrong. I hate you. But other than that, you know, it was really great. Thanks to everyone for showing up, and I hope to dominate next time.
Yeah, Ninja Panda sending you messages. I had Whole Milk sending me messages. Maybe that was the reason why I was all off.
All right.
It wasn't our fault. It was Chad's fault. There we go.
Yeah.
All right, very quickly before we separate here, let's go through some bombs just real quickly.
I got to pull up the show notes.
I'm going to give I'm going to give a dub bomb to EverQuest Mischief Server. I kind of like the idea, and they'd launched a second one where it's a classic progression server, which I kind of like those for games that I enjoy anyway. But then randomizing the loot so that you actually have the chance to pick up loot from another level appropriate thing across the entire world or in a different raid if you're fighting raid. But I like it. It's a nifty little thing. Jason, what do you got?
I'm giving a dub bomb to Guild Wars 2 for their going back to visit old stuff, the things that they're doing now. You get the episodes for free for the previous story chapters, but I've already got all those and when they showed they were doing it, it was like there's gonna be a meta achievement. You can do all these meta achievements with the old content. And you'll get a precursor in the next expansion. I'm like, oh man, it's gonna be like tons of work, but it actually hasn't been so bad. You just have to do the chapters and then do a little bit of adventuring in the zones that they were introduced in. So probably gonna actually go ahead and get that done at some point. So cool on them for putting out a not too bad a way for them to sort of make new content out of old and make it so that it's actually kind of rewarding without having to grind your face off.
Nice. Zach, what you got?
I'm going to do dub bomb to Swords of Legends Online. I did not expect that I would like the game. Went in with about thinking it was going to be an average game, but turns out it's a pretty good game, although pretty unoptimized at the moment. I'm hoping that they still have some optimization patches to roll out from the Chinese version, but and I'm also curious what the quality of the voice acting will be for the English voice acting, particularly because it's not in there yet. But I am optimistic because the combat's fun, the classes are fun, they feel very distinct. There's a lot of different customization going on there. Everything seems fairly balanced. And also the fact that you could fly all over the place is really neat, at least how they did it. Because the leveling path is fairly linear, but then you can go out and explore and do whatever you want in terms of flying around. So that makes it a bit more feeling open. So I'm just going to give a dub bomb to them. They deserve it.
Nice. From chat, Ninja Panda saying, a bomb to myself for missing last Saturday's gaming gumbo due to playing Mass Effect 2 and only realizing the time an hour and a half later. Well, that's why we put them on YouTube and on readycheckradio.com. Nasagra says, a bomb to Kurtzbell for taking so long to add PvP back to the game. I have a feeling that like a lot of people
PvE.
Speaking of like taking things a long time, there's gaming gumbo this week. Yeah, there's gumbo this week. Where it aka Mike B is guest hosting tomorrow with us with Jason and I. Didn't Valorant just add? Jason's covering it today. I think they added finally.
Really?
Abandoned stuff, remember?
That was Apex Legends.
Oh, Apex Legends, yeah. It's like, how is that not there already?
It was just for the one new mode they added. It wasn't that big a deal.
Yami Kami says, A-Bomb, I have to spend a lot of money for the pet vet for my other cat, and something in my PC broke, and I can't figure out what it is. That is definitely an A-Bomb. That has happened before.
That's awful.
Yeah. Hope your cat is okay, and hope you get that computer taken care of. Jason, go ahead.
That's why you don't let your pet, you don't let your cat inside the computer.
Yes. Yeah, I'm sure that's what happened.
Brechner Catalan, not really a bomb or anything. Just asking if you could mention the whole Black Desert Online moving publishers and the account deletion that's going to happen on the 1st of June.
Well, there you go. We mentioned it. Congratulations.
Yeah, I've been getting emails about that, and I'm like, I don't really care.
I mean, obviously we don't cover it because it's still buy to play, even though it's like a nickel most times. But yeah, there is the account migration of publisher changes there. So be aware. Go ahead, Zach.
Tycal 2399 says A-Bomb to the Jacksonville Jaguars, giving that guy doesn't deserve to be named a roster spot due to what is basically the NFL version of my dad's friend got me this cushy job is the reason you've always been and will continue to be trash. Question of the week. I think the basic version of Phantasy Star Online 2 should close when New Genesis comes out, but they'll probably wind up doing a RuneScape kind of thing where they keep both long term. As for me, though, unless New Genesis is a complete disaster, I'll only be playing it, and I'll leave the regular version by the wayside.
Yep. Other ones I broke up here, but that one was pretty quick, so I left them all together. Dishwisher chiming in, an A-Bomb drop every time we miss out on the drop of the intro song for the free-to-play cast, which would otherwise be so perfect to get people pumped and hyped for the show. A much more serious A-Bomb dropping on Google Play, making the refund request info sound like it wouldn't be a big deal to them to refund an accidental purchase out of courtesy, but then deny it because their policies won't allow it. I surely won't make something up that they can't deny next time. Pinky promise. Not even sure in hindsight that it was an accidental thing because the half-asleep touch on my phone, I assumed I couldn't have done it. Game wasn't installed on it, but on my PC's emulator. And the worst thing is, it's some rubbish overpriced unnecessary. More BS resource gains for a gacha game I don't even want to play anymore now, thinking my lost $11.99. Dubomb for Heroes of the Storm, not only developing a healthy community-driven esports scene, because they kind of had to, but finally receiving a pretty chunky update again, and with that unlocking for itself the umptheist still not dead ready, still not dead really, and the more new Overwatch content than actual Overwatch achievements. Now, Dishwisher, I did reply to on YouTube about the music, because yes, the drop is not in the intro music. It's in the outro music. And so I said, yep, it's there, but it's in the outro. And Dishwisher did reply saying, indeed it was, which hyped me up for the show I had just watched, basically forcing me to hit the replay button and watch it a second time all the way through. I see through your scheme, raking in those fat stacks of YouTube money from rewatches. Guess I'm lucky I managed to stop after the second watch. Could be stuck in a loop until the next episode airs. Yeah. Says it and continues binging on old episodes. Well, we definitely appreciate it. Yes, that is my evil scheme to get that fraction of a penny from your rewatch. And I don't know if you know, but you can skip to portions in videos. So you didn't have to rewatch the whole thing, but that's fine. We appreciate that you do. Go ahead, Jason, finish it off.
Box is giving an A-bomb to all the folks saying the cursor BS from Path of Exile is a non-issue. The same was said about loot boxes in the past, and look where we ended up now. Give these greedy folks an inch and they'll take a mile. I quit Path of Exile early on because of their loot box shenanigans. And seeing people defend even something like a paid curse or something that should be free in the first place, or better yet, have as an item you can earn in-game, is disappointing to say the least. I'm usually pretty good about ignoring this sort of thing for most developers because MMO publishers are pretty damn greedy with some of their microtransactions, but I expected better from grinding gear games. What's next? Charging for extra resolution options? Borderless for full screen options? Maybe even audio settings for your games? No thanks.
Slippery slope argument. Slippery slope argument.
Wasn't that just the style of the cursor, though? Or was it actually just the cursor?
It's the cursor style.
I mean, how it appears.
It's not like they take your mouse away unless...
Yeah, I mean, I was thinking to myself, okay,
the mouse looks like, that's all. Question of the week last week. Should the original PSO2 just close after New Genesis launches? Should it stay alive for a little bit and then close? Should it always just stay live? Are you really going to play it? Yami Kami chiming in saying, question of the week, it should just stay live. I hate it when games are shut down. Somewhere, someone really likes that game. Jason?
Dr. Catalan says, question of the week. New Genesis had been announced even before PSO2 made its way to Steam, so I never even considered playing the old version. I'll give this one a try when it comes to Steam, but I'm not in a hurry. I expect a lot of technical issues at launch.
I will say so far, and I haven't gotten to play it on Steam yet, I unfortunately have to use the Microsoft Store for the betas and stuff. There really hasn't been a lot of technical stuff going on. Go ahead, Zach. Finish it up.
Yep. Box says, personally, I dropped off Phantasy Star Online 2 for the same reason both Mike and Jason did, with New Genesis being basically right around the corner and nullifying any progress you make besides cosmetics. Playing in the beta more or less solidified that opinion, because in the 3 hours I put into that was more fun than the 50 plus hours I put into the original Phantasy Star Online 2, whether it was prior to and post Steam launch. I don't necessarily seeing it shut down right away, but eventually Sega may just choose to pull the plug when it's not profitable to them anymore.
That's it. Probably what'll happen.
Possible.
Probably what'll happen.
Did they ever pull support for the first Phantasy Star, though?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Question of the week this week. You know what? We want you to give us your free-to-play trivia questions, and we'll try to answer them on next week's show. So put them in the YouTube comments along with your weekly bombs. Dub bomb for something good, A bomb for something bad in the world of gaming or life in general. Give us your Jeopardy free-to-play questions, but don't put the answers down there. Don't put them down there. You can let us know how we did in the comments of the following week's show. So you want to play Stump the Chump? Let's see if you can stump these three chumps. Until next time, Zach, where can everybody find you?
Everyone can find me on Twitter at Healtharian.
Mr. Winter.
Find me on Twitter at Winter Informal, streaming at twitch.tv/JasonWinter.
I'm Mike Byrne. You can follow me personally right there at MagicMan1, but more importantly, follow at MMOBomb on Twitter so we can let you know about all the giveaways and more. Don't forget, next Friday's stream, after the free-to-play cast, we'll be giving away tons of Neverwinter prizes. Stay safe. See you on the servers.